Mats Madu, we are the children, we are the children of God. Come, 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 we change our world, we have what it takes to do it smart and make it smart. Welcome to our Smart Do.
My viewers, welcome on board. This is Paul. I wish to take you through the male reproductive system. We cover that a system is a combination of several organs performing a common task. This is the main organ that is involved in the reproduction or lies to a new offspring. In the male reproductive system, we start by naming the parts. This is a skin, and this skin is known as the scrotum. Known as the scrotum. The skin is known as the scrotum. Then we have this one known as the testis. It is not one, there is another one on the other side. There are two testes. Then this is known as the epididymis. Epididymis, I want to make sure it fits here. This is the epididymis. The epididymis. Then this is known as the sperm duct. Sperm duct. And these ones are known as the grads. Can have several names, but we'll just name them the grads. Then we have the urethra. The urethra. Then we have the penis. Those are the parts of the male reproductive system. Let us just go through them. Scrotum. Testes. And testes are two. Epididymis. The sperm duct. The grads. The urethra. And the penis. Then after that, these parts are in the external part, they are visible. So let us look at one part at a time, functions of every part, the functions of every part. To start with, let us start with the scrotum. The scrotum. And with the scrotum, this is a skin. This is a skin that encloses the testes. It is a skin that encloses the testes, that encloses the testes. Number two, with the same scrotum, what is the function? Number one, it is to enclose the testes. Number two is to regulate temperature. Regulate temperature. For proper sperm production, because sperms are produced in the testes, they need slightly lower temperature than the human body. That's why the testes are not found inside the body. They are found outside the body, suspended on the scrotum, so that they can be on a lower temperature than the body temperature. So that's what I'm saying, it regulates the temperature by being away from the normal body. Then we go to the testes. What is the function of the testes? The function of the testes, the two of them, is produce male sex cells, known as sperms. Produce sperms. And the sperm has a head and a nucleus. That's a sperm. It has the head, this is known as the nucleus, then it has a tail. This tail helps it to swim in the semen. So the testes produce sperms in many of them. Anytime they mature, they are stored here, ready for the disease. The mature sperms are produced and stored in the epididymis. So epididymis. The epididymis stores mature sperms stores the mature sperms. The epididymis stores the mature sperms. Then the sperm duct discharges or transports the sperms from the epididymis to the glands. Transports sperms from the epididymis to the glands. What is the importance of the glands? Why the glands here? We have a bladder here where urine is stored. So the glands must control urine, that sperms and urine cannot flow at the same time. Number two, sperms are tiny. They cannot flow to the body alone. They need a fluid. So that fluid is secreted in the glands in which the sperms swim. So we say that the glands, number one, produce semen. And semen is the fluid in which the sperms flow. They are able to swim with their tail in this fluid up to the uterus. Then the glands are also able to regulate the flow of urine and the sperm duct. They cannot flow at the same time. It is the semen also is used to clean the urethra so that it cannot have the urine particles. Then the urethra discharges urine and sperms. To the outside body. It flows outside. Then the penis deposits sperms in the vagina or the birth canal in the males. Those are the functions of the different organs. One point you have to note: urethra transports two products, the sperms and the urine. But sperm does transport sperms only. There are two testes that produce the male sex cells. And in females, the urethra is not part of the reproductive system, but in males, the urethra is part of the reproductive system. Thank you for viewing.